What y'all protesting for? Why don't you protest in my yard? My backyard. My backyard sky.
Backyard sky.
It was the 3rd of September. That day I'll always remember. Yes, I will.
Outside the White House. Joining me now, Brandon Tatum, former Tucson, Arizona police officer and the co-founder of the Blexit Foundation. Brandon, you said that you don't believe in taking a knee, which has become a very popular way to express solidarity with this movement.
Yeah, I don't believe in disrespecting the country. I don't believe in disrespecting my flag. I love America. America's been good to me. I understand that we've had some things in the past that have gone astray, but we've corrected it. We're united. There is no more Jim Crow. There is no slavery. I think that if people will come together and focus on the things that we've been able to accomplish moving forward, we can be a more united country. But I will never, and I'll say that, and I hope the world can hear me, I will never disrespect my flag. I will never disrespect my country.
I think when you see someone use what appears to be, and you know this case will be investigated, but in general, what appears to be more force than necessary to apprehend someone, to bring them in to the station, which is the primary motive at that point.
Yeah, I agree with the first officer that made the comment that it's a training issue. You have to evaluate every situation as an independent situation. If an officer did something that is wrong, that person should be held accountable. I think it has very minimal to do with racism. I think it has a lot to do with training. I like to see officers do better. I want to see them held accountable. Here's another thing that I think we should be talking about as well is how do you get in a position where an officer is using force against you? I think as a community, as a police community, we need to educate these young people and talk to them about not resisting arrest and not being put in a position where an officer has to use force on you. Deal with it in court. You can live to see another day. I'm glad that the gentleman didn't lose his life, but I'm holding police officers to the highest standard, and I hate to see police officers not do the best that they could do.
Next week's vote that will decide whether the statue stays or goes.
Take it out! Take it out!
This afternoon, Allendale's Veterans Garden of Honor became a battlefield for public debate. At the center of the controversy, this statue, showing a Confederate and Union soldier standing back to back with a slave child in between them.
Take it down, take it down.
Civil rights activists coming together in protest, demanding the statue be removed.
Confederacy, which stood for racism and stood for slavery, we don't think it should be up.
By those fighting to keep the statue as is.
USA! USA!
I'm here in support of the statue staying up. To me, the statue represents a war in our history in America that freed the slaves.
While some came armed with guns, others carried signs. Their exchanges were tense as the once peaceful park became polarized. Even the two veterans we talked to chiming in on opposite sides of the debate. One seeing history, the other seeing hate.
If that doesn't make you upset, that just blows my mind.
As a veteran, how does it make you feel?
Disgusted.
The statue actually shows unity. It's not racial a bit, okay? And if people would do the history on it, it doesn't mean a thing.
We're part of the Union. Why would we need a Confederate soldier for one? Why, it doesn't symbolize us coming together. No, we won and goodbye. You know, like that's it. Why do we need a slave at the feet of a Confederate and a Union soldier? Why is that necessary? Why is that what they chose to put up?
I'm backyard.
Bye.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is H.K. Edgerton. That stands for handsome and cool. I hail from, first of all, let me say, I am so very glad to see the police chief. Come around here, chief. Get yourself around here. Come on around. Y'all get a chief a bigger hand than that. My mama don't raise no fools. I want to thank the chief for coming. This is the second year that he's here. Chief, would you, anything you'd like to say?
I'd like to say I'm enjoying myself. I enjoyed myself last year, and I got a call yesterday to invite me today, and I'm glad to be here. Thank you all.
Three cheers for the chief. Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Hip, hip.
Hooray.
Y'all know I'm going to cut up. You can't wait to cut up around here. I am so very glad to see everybody, all my friends. I would hug all y'all. I don't see enough of my babies around here today, so next time y'all invite me around here, bring some of my babies. Don't make me have to get my flag and my signs out, because I got plenty of signs. It is, Charles, a great honor for me to be here. I think maybe y'all might be tired of seeing me every time I look around, come around this time. Where you going with the pretty girls? I have to watch all y'all. I have to watch the old men, the young men. Every time I look around, one of y'all got y'all's hands on my women. They all belong to me. I am so very honored to be here with my family to talk about these brave men, and I'm not going to forget about the women. You know, every Memorial Day we come around, we talk about the brave Confederate soldier. We know he was the bravest soldier ever lived. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
There's no doubt about that. But Lord have mercy, let us not ever forget the Southern woman. Amen. There ain't nothing like a Southern woman, but unless you got two of them on your hand. Ain't, I know, Miss Sandra, that ain't me, ladies. Y'all know I'm a silver-tongued devil, but I ain't acting that bad.
Want to hear something?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
Let's get this twist. Well, I'm just a good old American boy with a heart that's red, white, and true. Dreaming of the girl with the red hair and freckles in her eyes like the skies of blue.
Country music.
Yeah, I grew up in Texas, you know, so.
All right.
And keep her safe from the homies in the wrong side of town where they're smoking the reefer and acting like clowns. Keep that pretty white dress from getting dirty and brown, cause that's the American way. Woohoo!
Oh. Pretty racist song.
Racist against who?
Oh, black people.
Black people? But I'm black.
Well, keeping the redheaded girl away from the homies on the wrong side of town.
Homies? Come on, brother, there's all kinds of homies. You know, you white homies, Asian homies.
No, homies are black.
No, I think you're making them black, man. I mean, I think that's your stuff. You hear the twang, and then you assume that it's racist. But that's just what country music is like. Here, look, you're gonna like this one. You like this one.
All right.
Some folks wear their hats way off to the side with their pants down low and a gun tucked inside. Take their beer by the 40 and their chicken deep fried. I think we all know who we're talking about. The only dark I like is when I turn off the lights. The only hood I love is pointy and white. Can't trust you if I can't see your face at night. I think we all know who we're talking about.
Wait, hey, stop that. That's racist.
What's what? What is racist about it?
The only hood I love is pointy and white?
Yeah, man.
That's talking about the Klan, man.
Jackson, he wants to know, can you maintain your position?
Well, General Jackson, unless I get reinforcements, I must be forced back. But I'm going on while I can.
Reinforcements, yes, sir.
If hate had been the prevailing emotion between the races, then it is a safe bet that the Confederacy would have never been born. Now, let me just stop there. Did you hear what he said? If hate had been the prevailing emotions between the blacks and the whites in the South, He is saying it's a safe bet that the Confederacy would have never, ever been born. I continue. Fortunately, he says, there was love, understanding, and compassion. Now listen to what this black man says. And the two greatest lies ever perpetrated by history are, number one, that the South instigated the war, and number two, that it was fought by the North for the purpose of freeing the slaves. The Negro was merely used as the excuse for that war, while the real reason for it is reflected in every area of our lives, where the tentacles of government form the bars of a new slavery. No, don't furl that Confederate battle flag. Let it wave all across the South to remind Americans that there exists here a yearning for liberty, freedom, and independence that will not be denied. Let it fly as a testimonial to real men and real women who would rather work and fight than shed tears and beg for governmental charity, end quote. Amen. He understood, folks.
That's the way I feel. Screaming Black Lives Matter, or the black guys rather be dead beats than pay your bills. Yelling nigga this and nigga that. Call everybody nigga and get a nigga mad. As soon as I say nigga, then everyone react and wanna swing at me and call me racist cause I ain't black. We'll pound that then. Talking about slavery like you was around back then. Like you was picking cotton off the fucking ground back then. Like you was on the plantation getting down back then. Alright, look. I see a black man aiming his gun, but I'd rather see a black man claiming a son. And I don't mean just for one day and you done. I mean, you still trapped in a rut. And I work my ass off and pay my taxes for what? So you can keep living off free government assistance, food stamps for your children, but you still trying to sell them for some weed and some liquor, or a fucking babysitter while you party on the road cause you ain't got no fucking goals? You already late. You motherfuckers need to get your damn priorities straight. Wait, it's like you're proud to be fake, but you lazy as fuck. And you rather sell drugs than get a job and be straight. And then you turn around and complain about the poverty rate. Fuck out of my face! You can't escape problems. You can pray for some change, but can't break a dollar. Got nobody else to blame, so you blame Donald. They fuck the world with a Make America Great condom. My voice been back. I'm not racist. My sister's boyfriend's black. I'm not racist. My sister-in-law's baby cousin Tracy got a brother and his girlfriend's black. My head's in the cloud. Heard it's not enough jobs for all the men in your house. Maybe we should build a wall to keep the Mexicans out. Or maybe we should send them all to the ghetto for now. I'm not racist, and I never lie, but I think there's a disconnect between your culture and mine. I worship the Einsteins, study the Steve Jobs, but you ride Tupac's dick like he was a fucking god. Oh my god! And all you care about is rapping and stunting and being ratchet, and that's the nigga within you. Music rot in your brain and slowly start to convince you. Then you let your kids listen and then the cycle continues. Blame it all on the menu, blame it on those drinks, blame it on everybody except for your own race. Blame it on white privileges, blame it on white kids, and just blame it on white citizens. Aim at the vice president. Watch your class clowns. Niggas kneeling on the field, that's a flag down. How dare you try to make demands for this money? You gonna show us some respect, you gonna stand for this country, nigga.
Backyard Sky, baby! Bastard! You wanna fight me?
Please!
Here trying to sing about a tire swing. Right off an entire genre of music.
The banjos are strumming and the drums are banging. Let's get the boys together and have ourselves a hanging. Oh, damn.
I'm Backyard Sky.
Excuse.
Good help is hard to find. You see, the truth of the matter is this. The Emancipation Proclamation was not only unconstitutional, and everybody recognized it, it cost the Republicans a lot of elections. There were five northern states that refused after that to elect Republicans to Congress. And moreover, there were a lot of Union soldiers that deserted because of it and refused to fight. Slavery was not the issue. Slavery has never been the issue until recently, until political revisionists and the political correct people wanted to make it the issue. There have been numerous warnings down through history concerning our flag and concerning our heritage and our culture. One of those warnings came from General Patrick Cleburne. And I want to read to you what General Patrick Cleburne said in January of 1864. And he was warning the South in regards to subjugation. You talking about a prophet? Listen carefully. General Cleburne said this, if the South lost, it means that the history of this heroic struggle will be written by the enemy, that our youth will be trained by Northern school teachers, will learn from Northern school books their version of the war, will be impressed by all of the influences of history and education to regard our gallant dead as traitors and our maimed veterans as fit subjects for derision, end quote. Folks, let me tell you, that is exactly what has happened in this country.
Backyard!
You pick up any textbook that you want to pick up, and it'll just simply say, the war was over slavery, the North was right, the South was wrong. And most folks believe that, John.